to the Way Match Stadium for today's Panorama National League South match between Salisbury FC and Torquay United in association with New Balance, the league's official kit and ball sponsor. And thank you very much to...
We didn't know this.
No. Into the danger area it comes. No flick on, but awkward in the box. Bouncing overhead. Oh. Over the bar from Noah Coppin.
So, yeah, as Andy was alluding to, that throw we didn't know he had. And he's been here since he was a kid.
come from nowhere. It's a bit like Rory Delap when Tony Pulis discovered he used to do javelin as a kid. Couldn't really get a big purchase on it, but Salisbury now able to clear and look to break with Josh Hedges as he crosses the halfway line, goes past his man, goes a good turn of pace against Hayfield, and then drills the ball all the way to the other side of the box. Good touch by Noah Coppin, who hits it, drags it, and that might even go... No, it's gone behind for a goal kick. Went out very near the corner flag, though. Good break from Salisbury, though.
Yeah, I was writing notes at the time, but yeah, thank you, word for it.
Good bit of pace from Josh Hedges to... It will be Young, who... puts the ball into the wall, and Salisbury able to clear. Josh Hedges will try and make life difficult for Torquay as they try to reassert themselves on the attack, and it's into the box, and that will drift just wide of Lincoln's upright, who looks to get Salisbury going again, but thinks better of it.
I thought that wall looked very close, actually. I don't think it looked the full 10 back, if I'm honest. I wasn't going to complain at the time.
No.
But yeah, I thought...
But it was Josh Hedges trying to work a little bit of space for himself. And it's Callum Watts who plays it out left. Gordon Raguet looking with two men. They're doubling up on Salisbury's wide men. Callum Watts outside of him, though. Race to get there down by the byline. Does well. Keeps the ball in play. Crosses towards the defender. It won't quite find a Salisbury player as it's... flicked clear by not sure defender or goalkeeper. Salisbury still with the ball, swung in towards the back post, headed clear. Looks to be playing in midfield for Torquay. Ball forward, and there's a foot race now. Young's the first one to it. He's covered by Summerton, who slips, and he's curled it into the post, and it's half away, but another attack, and Josh Summerton puts the ball behind, and that's the best chance of the game so far as Torquay hit the post. Dramatic action here at the Raymac, but Salisbury survive, and the long ball forward is flicked on by Prask, and it's Young causing problems and looking to create danger as Salisbury unable to clear it. There's a tangle of legs, and there is a penalty for Torquay United after a tangle between Carroll and a Torquay player just inside the penalty area. 83 minutes on the clock, and it was... the whistle's been blown for a little while. Park calming himself and puts it into the back of the net. With 85 minutes on the clock, it's Salisbury 0, Torquay 1. Cody Cook in the 85th minute. Salisbury will feel slightly aggrieved. I can see why the referee's given that decision. She wants to get on with the game and is trotting over to the celebrations.
I'm going to have to leave.
She has her whistle in her mouth, but hurry up, Hammond.
I'll just say a very quick goodbye to everybody in case I don't make it back on there.
And that is the full-time whistle. It ends here. Torquay United, the victors. Salisbury 1, Salisbury 0, Torquay 1.